help me in a teacher training I'm doing that starts Saturday. She's one of four people I teach with. I've been teaching this tantra now since 1978 and started as a yoga teacher in 1967. So Mare is what's known as a Dakini or Shakti woman, a sexual high priestess. She has incredible orgasmic Shakti, spiritual sexual energy, which she's able to transmit. She specializes in work with single men and women and also couples having to do around sexual mastery, sexual healing, and has cured hundreds of men of impotency. She knows 22 strokes for a penis besides this one. As you'll learn, touch is more touch is about energy, and that's what we're going to be learning tonight, the physical and energetic manifestation of touch and how to use it and where to use it on a woman's body. So Mare, since she was around, I said, well, you know, I'm going out tonight. I'll take you to dinner if you wouldn't mind coming and being a demo. So this having a demo is, I feel we're blessed, because it'll be a lot easier for you to get a feel of things, seeing it demonstrated. All right. If you ever get a chance to have a private session with a Dakini such as Mare Simone, avail yourself of such a session. Though it can be therapeutic, it's like going to a coach. Like you want to drive the ball on a golf course straighter, you go to someone that's really good. This is the great Mare Simone. She actually, that is her name in Tantra circles. She's been publicized more as a Tantra teacher than any other woman.
Oh, AOL?
AOL featured front page. There she was. The woman who'd love 5,000 men. They puffed it up a little bit, but she is a teacher of love. And she is a high priestess, and I'm happy to have her here. All right. Thank you so much for your questions. Yeah.
I ask you if you felt that that answered your question about expanding orgasm and not ejaculating.
It answered generally, and I realize that there are practices that are more detailed than to go into right now.
I'd like to address it a little bit.
I would love to hear what you're saying.
Because I teach that a lot. That's one of the things that I do consistently. I think that's one thing that a lot of men really want to learn, how to expand the orgasm, how to last longer, how to ride the waves, especially when the partner is feeling really turned on, so that they can assist her in having full orgasmic pleasure without ejaculating themselves, so that she can have the multiple orgasms that she's capable of having. And I think it's important, first of all, to kind of measure stages of your arousal so that you can recognize when you're at a manageable place and hold that space and kind of spread it out. And then when you feel like you're reaching a place where you're almost at the point of no return, to take a moment to pause and integrate the energy and spread it through a deep breath and also making sound, so that then you can move your own energy up through your body. And then you start to feel more tingly and more vibrant in your body, also using your muscles to contract and pull the energy up. You're breathing it in and visualizing it rising up your spine, and then if you express it and emanate it, it helps to release the intensity of pressure that you're building down there. So it's kind of like taking 6 inches and spreading it up to 6 feet throughout your whole body. And when you start to feel that, as soon as you begin to feel the fullness of your body becoming more almost like engorged, one of my clients likes to call it a full body erection, because you begin to feel this energy tingling throughout your whole body. And when you start to feel that, it's less imminent. Then the feeling isn't so urgent, and you can play more because you're feeling it all over your body. It's not just down there. So it's really about connecting it more. And if you can check, okay, I'm at a 6 right now. That's a playful space. I know I'm not going to come yet. I'm going to spread that energy around and, you know, emanate it and radiate it and project it to your partner, and then there's more energy to play with. Because if you're always holding back, I think what men do a lot is they're often holding back, like, oh, I'm feeling like I'm going to come, and trying not to feel too much so that they don't feel more than they can handle. But when you start to open your body and spread it, then there's just much more space for pleasure to move. And then you start having those full body orgasms we're talking about.
Just because you touched on, you touched on the man's role, I, on the opposite hand, have like really hot women in my past that are like always charged. And I've gone through that, like, I am always going through that, actually, of like trying to move the energy. Mm-hmm. And so I'm just curious to get the other side, and how do you calm her down? How do you like move the energy through her, you know? And like, I mean, Charles definitely has schooled me over the years with this, for the past 8 years or so. But just
would
like to hear your input.
Thank you. I think that's a really interesting question, and untrained women who don't know about Tantra don't really realize that men have a greater capacity than they think, that it's their role to make a man ejaculate, and that if he doesn't, then they failed. And so when a woman has that fixation that he's supposed to release, and he's trying to build the energy and then ride bigger waves, it creates sort of a mismatch in the energetic fields. So a woman needs to at least have some tantric background to know how to take pauses and really feel the radiance of light and the joy of being in stillness sometimes. Yeah, what's really sexy is when you're in that moment of a pause, or when you want to take a pause, just to really pour the love out your eyes, mm-hmm. pour all that energy out your hands or some other part of you, and say something that's, an expression of your love. And then that becomes a mind gasm, a heart gasm, a whole feeling of love. Great question.
Dinner?
Yeah, we're talking for dinner.
I'm actually going to jump in just one thing. There's a real quick on what you just mentioned, because it's one of these instances that I've had two very simple things. One that's not nearly as elaborate and subtle is just the benefit of simple massage sometimes. I mean, for transmuting energy, moving energy, if it's to calm you, massaging shoulders, even with a woman, calming her, putting a hand on her heart, something. Mm-hmm. And it's often that you need to, Mary, you're totally right, you need to actually be the one to step forward. And mm-hmm. and the other thing is, if you have a meditation practice together, meditating on emptiness, that kind of thing, feeling what it's like to have that stillness presence at the same time, that's a whole other... That's all
about, just to do it. Yeah, we do a lot of massage. I mean, it's a really important part of what making.
Beautiful. Thank you so much. Wonderful, amazing presentation.